Salut tout le monde, rebonjour, nous sommes toujours mardi et on est reparti pour une nouvelle carte, hein, cette fois pour le pistolet à poudre.
La musique, ça charge, d'accord, c'est intéressant. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ben, j'ai rien raté. J'ai rien raté parce qu'il s'est rien passé. Bon, alors. Bon petit café, ça va faire du bien. Comment ça va les copains? How are you doing guys? parce qu'il fait ce bruit. Hello. Now you know. How are you doing? Bonsoir, bonsoir. Is it night time? In your place? So yeah, still like 3 o'clock in the afternoon. So good afternoon, my friend. It's a very, very, very quiet afternoon. I was starting to wonder if my checkbook is not broken. So in case you wonder, I'm still working on my common arsenal for the game. It's the before last one for the deck to be complete. It's 30 of them in total. Maybe it's sunny in most of Europe. All these weeks of bad weather, people run out. Yeah, maybe. That may be what happened. Because usually I'm always with somebody's talking, you know. And today I started at 9:30. I had Ma who came just a little bit before the end of my stream this morning, after 2.5 hours. And there it's been like 1 hour and 13 minutes, and there the first one was popping up. But yeah, job is being done, so no matter. It's just a little bit more boring. Okay, what we gonna do in here? First, need to figure out what's going on here. is not bad.
Hey, Drovana!
With this character, I assume it will be a strategy game with army and stuff. Yeah, that's what it is. It's a war game. And right now I'm working on those cards, which will help you creating your army. So you will have to choose one weapon for contact weapon, like, you know, sword and axes and stuff like that. So yeah, you choose a weapon, you choose an armor, and you choose a throwing weapon as well. And for that you have a deck of cards that you know, help you out to know what you have in your units. So that's what that card is about. It's about powder pistol. This is the last two. I have a bigger gun and this one, and then I'm done for the common arsenal, and I will be able to go to the magic weapon, the magic object.
I discovered it because of you suggest him somewhere for a raid. The streamer didn't see it and I came to check by my own.
Good Drovana. Yeah, magic. Yeah, that's gonna be a little bit more interesting. I'm gonna change the way I'm presenting the object, because I don't want to do, you know, characters anymore. We have enough of those for the arsenal, the common arsenal. So I will just do the object itself with a surrounding to showcase it. Like if, you know, like if it's being stored somewhere or exposed on something. Because those objects are quite unique, so it's strange to have a particular race holding it or using it. As it, you know, I don't know, I just feel like it's best to do those objects by themselves. And we will have a better look of them that way as well. Because, you know, common weapons are commons. You know, they are common, we know. We kind of know what they look like. But those objects, you know, we need to have a good view of them. So, they will fill up the whole space of the card. Hero cards? Like, what you mean by hero cards? Like, cards that are a little bit better than the others, or what do you mean by hero cards? What's gonna happen is that all the magic objects have a price, you know? So you can use it in your army if you know, if you pay for it.
So that's Gandalf instead of Wizard of 28.
Oh! Specific person with a story and name? No! That's what I was talking about. Though this deck I'm about to start is all about objects. So it will be like magic swords, magic rings, you know, all kind of objects that have magic power. But there won't be any people in there. I choose to, you know, to draw people for the common arsenal. And I feel like, you know, for the magical object, I feel like it's best if I'm only draw the object itself. Or maybe if it's a ring, maybe I will see a hand or something, but not a specific person. Those guys will have their own portraits in the codex of a specific race. Like, we're gonna create heroes, you know, with every races, but those guys, the cards of those guys will be on their storybook. But that's not for now. Now I have tons of. When I think about it, it took me since September to draw the 30 common weapon cards. So like September, October, November, December, 3 months. 3 months, so that means I'm about average of 10 cards a month. So if I keep working that pace, the magic object will be finished in 6 months' time. So in June, I will finish.
Jesus Christ.
Yes, I mean, what happened in our game is that you're not playing. That's the little twist of our game. You're not playing the guys on the table. You're playing a master warrior, a maître guerrier, which is a divine person that controls that little army. So it's kind of a role play, because, you know, so like when you have tournaments, you know, every master warrior are, you know, fighting with their own weapon, their army, and you can even have a divine input in your army, because we have what we call the Master Warrior Point. It's a token that you can play to help out your army to be more successful in one specific move. So you start with just one point, and more you prove that you're a very good master warrior, and more points you can get. And it's like 5 maximum of points you can get. So it's kind of a rank of how good you are as a master warrior. And you can earn those points by writing down scenarios and helping us, you know, make that game a good game. You can earn those points by drawing stuff that's gonna help us making that game a better game. And you can earn those points by, you know, winning battle on the battlefield during tournament. This telephone has to stop. Come on, stop now. Stop, stop, stop. He's not listening. Thank you. So you're not playing a hero or anything, you're playing a god. But you're the one who did create that army, so you can place any hero you like there. And you're the big hero of that army, like the one that is giving orders, have a direct connection with his god, you. So somewhere, somehow, you kind of he's that hero. But yeah, the idea is more like, you know, you're telling to the commander of that army what to do. But what is very fun about that game is that the main purpose of it is to play with the mini you have at home. So if you have, you know, if you like to buy minis and paint them and play around with them, like, you know, transforming, and you want to create a very specific and badass hero, you'll be able to play that hero because you will have a big toolbox where you can pick up any weapon there is, any magic object or common, you know, common weapon that is available to you to create your army, and really make that mini exactly, you know, the on paper exactly the way it is on the mini. And if that mini is not, you know, if the race is not there yet, you can even ask us. Okay, I have that mini that I want to buy. What characteristic I can give him? And you know, we will look at it and tell you what race it is and what characteristic is for that mini if it's not out yet. Because we have the characteristic of every race that we planned to do for phase one. And for now, officially there are only three. It's like the Arcanians, which are the Romans guy, the Dwarves, and the Orcs. But yeah, there are many more to come. Because the goal is to have every race you can find available, so you can play any of your mini. This game is gonna develop in a lot of different ways, year after year. That's very exciting. When I see what we had 2 years ago, which is nothing, because they were, you know, 2019. There were no visual of the game, and I started to draw a little bit in 19, and then a little bit more seriously in 20, and then I got really excited and decided to work full gear for the game in 21. That way, you know, stuff really starting to grow. So I'm not counting 19 and 20 as 2 years. I'll count that for 1 year, and so in 2 years it's been a lot that's been drawn already. So I guess, you know, give me one more year, and I should have done, you know, a lot of other things, and we will have, you know, artists, or you know, at least people that like to draw and would like to improve their skill, starting to ask around if they can participate to the game. So I may have a bigger team quite soon. I was curious, you for example draw fence boots of awesomeness as magic object, and later you draw a general, maybe he will wear those boots. I mean, yeah, I'm gonna draw around 60 magic objects, and it's gonna be up to you to choose whatever you want for your hero. So imagine you have, I don't know, your hero have boots, and you know, you like him to be able to walk double as fast as his, you know, his normal speed is, and sure enough, you know, amongst magic objects there is those boots that make, you know, the owner walk the double, you know, double speed that he's supposed to walk, and you can just pay for the price of the magic object and pick it up for your hero, and sure enough he can walk very fast. Yes, I mean, what's gonna be fun is that on the book there is already 60 objects, alright? So that's gonna be the official magic object of the deck you will buy, you know, when you're gonna buy the deck. But, and I like that but, cause we're gonna create a treasure cards that are gonna be for we're gonna send those cards randomly for good players that, you know, are involved in the grow of the game, So every time there is something to buy, they buy it for themselves because they like the game and they want the game to grow. So as a thank, as a thank you, we will send like treasure cards. And those and what's fun about those treasure cards is that it can be anything. It can be like a magical wing of awesomeness that we have to decide what it does. It can be yes, exactly. I mean, they won't be unique, but it's way possible that there only be like 25 of them and that's it. So you may end up with a very, you know, collectible cards in there. And what we're gonna start to put in place, and we're gonna have a meeting about that next week, actually, is a trading point, a commercial point, that we're gonna send to those guys as well. And for now, they don't really know what's gonna, you know, be used for. But what's gonna be used for is that on every magic card, they will have a value, a commercial point value. And so the only way to, for example, sell this card, you know, in the game, I'm not talking about real money here, I'm talking about in the game between players. If you want to sell that card to another player, you will, you know, the player will have to pay you with those commercial points. If you want, or you can just exchange it for, you know, cards that have the same value, or you can just amicably, you know, friendly, you know, I mean, we want to have something that connect the players together. And sometime you may have like an orc army like me. I'm an orc, so I don't really care about the dwarves, but I got, you know, a magic weapon for dwarves only. Because it's specific to the dwarves. But my friend have an orc weapon and he's playing the dwarves. So yeah, maybe we can have a deal here, and so I can reach him and say, you know, during, or even when, you know, the game is gonna grow and we get tournament on clubs, that all those guys that starting to have unique cards reward in their pockets, you know, they start, you know, they be able to, you know, exchange cards, because, you know, he sees that this guy is an orc and maybe have a magic card, and so we can, you know, we can start talk together again and ask around, you know, especially when it will be big big tournament, we'll be there as well with those cards in their pocket, in our pocket, and we're probably gonna distribute them randomly as well. So yeah, so there is the cards that needs to be done officially for the decks, and there will be a lot of cards that will be done just for fun, and we'll have a pack of those that we're gonna open and, you know, randomly distribute to everybody. So that's gonna be a fun part as well, because it can be anything, you know, it can be, you know, craziness, it can be something serious, it can be something like very serious on the game that you can't get anywhere else or elsewhere. That's going to be fun to produce. And the big question I wonder, and I'm going to talk about it with Sebastian, I'm wondering if it's not a good idea to have those cards and colors, because it's the same price. I check on, you know, website where you can do professional playing cards, and they don't talk about white and black or colors. It's the same price. So I'm wondering if all those unique magic cards are in colors, straight away you see that it's special cards. You know what I mean? It's a special one because it's in color, you can't get it on the pack. So if you have it, it's because you probably gonna, you know, you earn it from something or somewhere, or during a tournament, or because you did buy something, or because you've been lucky enough to get something that, you know, made you get that card. Or maybe you did draw some stuff for the game, or maybe you did write something for the game, and as a thank you, you got a card. But I think it would be fun if the cards are not only with object that is not in the deck, the original deck, but you know, you can see straight away that they are not common cards. What is that? I mean, the basic is there. Every idea that, you know, get me excited, I just want to do it. That's as simple as that, you know, because it's all built on, you know, pleasure and fun. So as soon as you find a fun idea, and that, you know, you're not driving by earning money or anything, the drive is just having fun, you can't do anything you want. That's the beauty of it. It will take time, but you can do anything you want. And actually, what I'm wondering is, am I gonna start the official magic object first, or am I gonna start this special, unique reward card first? Because if we are starting to sell goodies and, you know, deck of cards and stuff like that, we need to have those packs ready. Already, if you see what I mean. So I guess I'm gonna start by those special cards. That will be a nice break from serious stuff for the game. Even though everything is for fun, it would be nice to have colored cards as well. Yeah. So I know already that Sébastien has a lot of magic weapon, that magic object that is not on the rule book yet. So I will start with those. Unicorn pen. Did you see my unicorn pen? Yeah, I will be able to use it if I'm doing colored drawing. It's almost 4 already. Okay, the main character is almost done. Oh, I still have his helmet to draw. What's cool about talking about unicorns, it made me think about the Bestia, the Beast book, where every beast will be. And that's something else that need to be drew. And what's fun about it is that we're gonna try to put in there every beast we know about. And I guess unicorn will be one of them, and Pegasus and stuff like that. And once again, if you want, you know, to have your big hero, the general of your army, riding a unicorn, just for fun, that's gonna be possible if you have the mini for it. But it's not that hard. You just have to have a horse and, you know, stick a horn in his front head, and then you have a unicorn. We just have to decide what's the specification of the unicorn. It can't be just a horse with a horn. Has to be something else. But that's something fun too. Imagine you're like very keen about those kind of beasts, and you have a book about those kind of beasts, and you have a good imagination what they can do. Maybe you can write down, you know, a lot of specification about those animals, and you just need to check it out and see if it's fun, if it's playable, and that could be. That could be a way to participate to the development of the game. That's just an example, but that's way feasible.
It stick.
Sorry. I was talking about model wise. That's not impossible. Okay, now, what about this helmet? Okay, now the helmet. Funny, cause I have to confess that I didn't made up that pose. I found that pose on with Google on the internet. I found a pirate holding that pose, and I thought, wow, that's a nice pose. It's exactly what I want for my for that card. So I stole that pose and made it as a medieval guy. And actually, I prefer my version without giving me any flowers. I think yeah, that version is more badass than this poor pirate I found. Hello, Denise! Ah, no, Denise, I'm gonna go in like 10 minutes. How are you doing today? Ladies and gentlemen, my first assistant, Denise. That John Mighty of the art department. I guess. I mean, you're working for it, so I guess you are in the team. See if I'm adding a pointy thing here. That will add something cool. Oh no. Maybe this little round thing here. I don't know, I want something here for some reason. Now it looks ridiculous. Okay, never mind. I won't add anything. Okay. Does that mean I'm done with that fellow that I need? All I need is to... You know that this morning I had time to start and finish one more card?
That was my 21 New Year resolution, really, to find a cool game and draw for it just before the end of...
Yes, that's amazing! You made it! Wow! Now the next goal is to have your art published for the game. Alright, let me show you what I did this morning. I did that dude this morning. With the AV crossbow. And yesterday evening I finished that dude here with the repetitive arbalet crossbow. And now I'm on that one. So I may finish this one on my own, depending on what's going on this evening. Or maybe if I'm starting, I don't think I will make it this evening. Thanks, I've been busy with creating some IT security material for my student today, but since I'm working from home, it's relaxing and gave break to say hi to you. How is your day? Days was quiet. I just starting to being able to chat with Tioseniso and Drovana, just like I don't know, an half hour ago, and the rest of the day was me and my drawings. And I draw since 9:30 this morning. So I made good progress, but I didn't talk too much. And now that it's time for me to go and pick up my kids at school, now I have people to talk with. But I guess I'll be back very soon to finish that drawing. And I made a pretty cool... we have better conversation than your drawing. Yes, I mean, yeah. It was a nice conversation because it gave me the idea of starting the... It gave me the idea of starting the special treasure cards before the magic cards. So I made this. You know, remember the chat we had yesterday about finding the nice reference. So I need to draw that gun, right? So I did do that, and I found people. I just cut out the arms, made the hand bigger, find a head that I like, and place it there. He won't look at us. He will look over there, like almost like he saw something behind him and he's about to turn. And I will make that weapon maybe a tiny bit bigger, and the end will be like a trumpet, you know. So the end have been emphasized as well. I like the horn there. So I mean, I got here everything I need for the drawing. You know, we can almost see it already. So that's it for that card. For this guy here, the it was way easier. I just found that pirate on, you know, with Google that has this position right there. And I just, you know, copy the position and dress him as a medieval guy instead of a pirate. And here I have my card because I really like the position he have. Hey, come on, little man. I'm about to leave. Emiliku, hello. I'm about to leave. I was talking and starting to say goodbye, and then here you come. I spent my fucking day on my own, and now that I'm gonna go, everybody's coming. Salut Thierry, salut, salut. Pour le chaos. Voilà, donc. J'étais en train d'expliquer un petit peu mon process de création en récupérant tous les trucs que j'ai besoin. En gros, j'ai l'idée dans ma tête de ce que je veux exactement. Merci. J'ai l'idée dans ma tête de ce que je veux exactement. Je reste pas, j'ai des bisous. De toute façon, je vais y aller de toute façon. Donc, merci d'être passé, merci pour le raid et à très bientôt. Donc, j'essaye de trouver les images que j'ai besoin. Sur internet et je fais un montage, je grossis, je rétrécis des trucs jusqu'à ce que j'ai quelque chose qui correspond à l'énergie de ce que j'ai besoin, et après j'utilise ça comme référence pour faire le dessin. Donc ça c'est ma prochaine carte que j'ai déjà, la dernière carte de l'arsenal commun, dernière carte, celle-ci c'est l'avant-dernière, elle est presque terminée, j'ai plus qu'à faire le fond. Et après, je vais attaquer des cartes trésors qu'on va distribuer aux gens qui vont commencer à acheter nos produits. Et pour les récompenser, on va leur envoyer des cartes trésors qui pourront soit utiliser pour leur armée, soit échanger avec d'autres joueurs, etc. etc. Donc ça va être assez cool. C'est un stylo à billes. Yeah, tout ça, c'est au stylo à billes et c'est marqué sur le coin. Donc merci beaucoup d'être passé. Je vous invite à repasser très très vite. Moi, je serai pour sûr jeudi. Attendez, quel jour là? On est mardi? Ouais. Jeudi, pour sûr, je travaille pour Maître Guerrier. Peut-être avant, selon les emplois du temps, les machins, les trucs, mais il y a peu de chance. Mais pour sûr, jeudi à partir de 9h30 du soir, je suis de retour pour finir l'arsenal commun. Donc merci tout le monde d'être passé. Il faut vraiment que j'aille chercher mes drôles maintenant. Sinon, ils vont être tout seuls à la porte de l'école. Merci d'être passé et des bisous. Et à très vite. Thank you very much for coming. And I will see you all very soon. All right. Ciao, ciao. Bye.
In case I don't see you. Good afternoon, good evening.